السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. اليوم حبدأ معاكم محاضرتنا لليوم Collapse Prevention Tools. By the end of this lecture, إن شاء الله, you will be able to identify the different tools that will help in prevention of the collapse, define the different measures in monitoring compliance or adherence to the central line insertion and maintenance. Now, the importance of physician eligibility for insertion of the central line. Now, how to do competency assessment for the physician and nurses for the central line insertion and care maintenance. Identify the difference of central lines related supply. As mentioned before by my colleague, what is the central venous catheter? Central venous catheter, it is important for life-saving device for critical care patients. واضح الصوت؟
واضح دكتورة منار, واضح.
طيب تمام. Central venous catheter for life-saving for critical care patients and increase associated with increased bloodstream infection and lead increase in morbidity and in mortality rate and length of the stay وبالتالي increase the cost. What is the CLABSI? CLABSI is defined as a laboratory confirmed bloodstream infection with central line device placed for more than two calendar consecutive calendar days. This is a flow chart pathway of the surveillance process, starting from availability of all resources that need for surveillance program. For example, availability of the desk, PC, network, manpower, qualified surveillance coordinators. All the team should be discuss the surveillance process. With interpretation of the rate and the intervention, then make checkup for availability of updated policy based on the updated guideline and the manuals and all documents with updated forms. Then positive blood cultures, then availability of the results and the check for حصن, quality of the data entry in the حصن plus system. Then doing visits, validation visits or supportive visits. Then communicate all the finding with ICU heads and the hospital director. Then formulate action plan with follow up by the hospital infection control and the surveillance coordinator in the regions. Then report to the GDI surveillance team in the GDBIPC. Then follow up for CLABSI indicators. CLABSI rate reduction strategy, starting from updating guidelines and subcommittee, then prepared and the creation of the toolkit by GDIPC surveillance team. Then perform action plan according to the assessment in the toolkit that should be prepared by the surveillance coordinator in the facility, then follow up by the regional coordinator. Then accordingly need to monitoring visits and follow up for the CLABSI indicators. What are the CLABSI prevention tools? It is Ibarra and auditing tools created by GDIPC surveillance team based on the evidence-based practice that help in prevention and the reduction of the CLABSI rate in the Saudi Arabia. This toolkit should be monitored monthly in all hospital, in regions, in all medical, adult medical surgical ICUs. This is the component of the prevention tools. Number one, authorized supervision letter, list of the eligible ICU physician to insert central line. The third one, competency assessment tools for ICU physician in central line insertion. The other one for the nurses related to the maintenance, competency on the maintenance. Then adherence monitoring form to monitor staff compliance to central line insertion practice, and audit to monitor compliance to central line maintenance practice, and on voluntary checklist for all the central line related supplies, roadmap assessment tool, and education and training for all ICU staff and documents. The first one in the toolkit, this is the first form that should be authorized letter. This authorized letter should be utilized by the ICU staff, should be assigned one person in the staff to be authorized and stop any malpractice related to the central line during insertion or maintenance, unless there is life-threatening condition, should be not stop the procedure. The other one, this is central line insertion eligible ICU doctors. This is list should be filled by ICU staff that eligible for central line insertion through a certification or competency assessment, and should be approved by medical director or and ICU head. The other forms, the central line insertion practice adherence monitoring, utilize this form by infection control practitioner to audit infection control practice during central line insertion. At least this should be performed twice per week. Then the next form here, central line maintenance
practice. دكتورة منور، هل الفورم جاهزة مع حضرتك بحيث نشير الفورم نفسها لأنها مش واضحة؟
الفورم مش موجودة، بس ممكن الاطلاع عليها
تقريها بس، أو يعني بحيث إن يعرفوا الكونتنت اللي فيها.
أنا بصراحة حاليا ما عملت لها أبلود يعني عندي على الجهاز، بس هي موجودة على
أول وصفة. بس حضرتك تقولي الكونتنت اللي فيها بحيث الكل يعرف ويرجع لها بعد المحاضرة إن شاء الله.
بصراحة يعني تقريبا هي صغيرة، الكونتنت مو واضحة أبيرنج الديتيلز اللي فيها، بس ممكن يرجعوا لها نهاية المحاضرة، ولو في أي كويشن ريجاردنج الديتيلز ممكن أني تايم. This form central line maintenance practice audit. This is also should be utilized by infection control practitioner to monitor the nursing staff regarding care and the maintenance and the dressing of the central line, and should be at least used twice per week. Competency assessment checklist. For central line insertion, this form should be performed annually for ICU physicians to assess the skills during central line insertion. Any physician not competent should be not allowed to perform central line. This is the other one. Competency assessment checklist for care and maintenance of the central line should be performed also annually for nursing ICU staff to assess the skills during maintenance and the insertion of the central line. This form, central line supply inventory checklist to monitor central line related supply availability and the saving time for preparing central line items during procedures. This form central line bloodstream infection roadmap assessment. This is already performed by surveillance coordinator in the regions, and all the content, if it is not applicable, should be work on it by the hospitals, and follow up of this action plan by regional coordinator. The component of this roadmap assessment, there is many components related to education and competency, the central line supplies, eligible doctors, and the updating forms with policy in the facility. This is the link. You can visit it for more information, to download also the forms. If you have any question, we can contact, you can contact us on our surveillance Gmail. And this is our reference. شكرا لكم. في أي سؤال للريفرنس؟ وهنا اللينك للجي دي اي بي سي، بإمكان الاطلاع على جميع الفورمات المستخدمة خلال الاستراتيجية.